We all know electricity is not the friendliest of natural phenomena. We have a love-hate relationship, science and I. Regardless of how you deal with your bottled energy, when dealing with science, it's essential to take the proper precautions. In this episode of What's What, we are going to talk about safety in regards to electricity, give you some recommendations, and even invite one very special guest. But before we get started, don't forget to subscribe below, give us a like, or drop a comment. Whether it be our cell phones, lights, computers, or cars, we use electronic devices every day. Even at home, there is electricity all around us, with outlets coming from every wall. The voltage and current running through these outlets pack enough power to... well, you know. Electricity packs a lot of power. That's why it is important to always, and I mean always, take precaution. Even when it comes to changing a light bulb, make sure you unplug the lamp first. Trust me, you don't want to come into contact with a hot wire. Electricity can strike when the motion of electrons is disrupted within a given conductor, as we talked about in a previous episode. But here is a question. Why is electricity so harmful to us human beings?
Hey, I can answer that.
Hi, Vanessa. You never miss a cue.
Just hang in there, Frederick. I have some information that's going to blow your mind. No pun intended. Actually, speaking about puns and minds, please check out my channel Braincraft after this episode. Hey, it's me again, here to talk about electricity and anatomy. Two things that go hand in hand, right? Not really. Generally speaking, our human body is actually more conductive than the ground we stand on. Now, this is mostly because our human bodies are made up to 60% water, which is a little weird, I know. If our body somehow comes into touch with an electrical circuit, it captures some of that current, and in turn, we become part of the circuit that we're in contact with. Electricity will literally try to force its way through our bodies, and we all know how that ends. Now, some of you are probably thinking, don't our bodies have electricity in them? And the answer, of course, is yes. Your brain actually produces enough electricity to power a small light bulb. The signals that our body uses to communicate between our brain and our muscles use electricity, especially with the heart. So when we come into contact with an outside electrical current, it interferes with our vital functions. It leads to spasms in the muscles, and it can even lead to a cease in heartbeat and breathing. That's a macabre note to finish on, Frederick, but that's all I've got for you this week.
Thanks for covering those safety tips, Vanessa. I hate to steal your thunder, but today we have another guest to explain hazards and safety measures. Here is Claudio from our Nexans facility in Chile.
Hello, Wildwaters. I'm happy to be here to talk to you. So let's get right to it. You're probably familiar with the term short circuit, but what is a short circuit and how exactly does it happen? A short circuit occurs when a current travels along an unintended path between two conductors of an even electrical potential. This results in an excess of current flowing through the circuit, which can lead to breakage, heating, ignition, or even explosion. And if a human comes in contact with a short circuit, things can get very, very scary. And in regard to safety measures, here are some quick points to follow when working with electricity. Rule number one, water and electricity do not mix. So remember to always keep your electronic devices away from liquid. Watch those hair dryer, folks. It's a good idea to keep liquids away from your computer too. No. And that speaker, while you are on a float in the middle of a pool, you know, like you see in the movies, yeah? Don't do that. Please don't do that. And never, ever Swim while it's storming outside. Número dos. Handle power cords with care. To prevent overloads, always check your wattage and make sure your cords can handle the right amount of electricity. Never do octopus connections. Keep cords away from oil and watch out for heat. Hot outlets or cords are red flags and usually mean unsafe conditions exist. Rule number 3. Switch your power tools off before connecting them to a power supply and make sure to keep your cords out of the way during use. Disconnect the power cords connected to your tools when you are finished working and tape extension cords to the walls or floors when necessary. Rule number 4. Whether you are flying a kite or up on a ladder, stay away from overhead lines. Rule number 5. Never cover light with fabric. And rule number 6. In the event of a hazardous electrical incident, disconnect the power source. Now, let's talk about consequences. Sending out an SOS. Sending out an SOS. Remember Peter Parker's principle. Great power comes with great responsibility. Did you know that 30% of domestic fires occur due to electrical faults? These fires can start from overheating, a short circuit, or an electrical overload, generally due to one of the following circumstances: incorrectly installed wiring, poor tightening of connections, defective of improper plugs, overloaded circuits and extension cords, malfunctioning fuses and circuit breakers, and misuse or poor maintenance of appliances. For us, electricians who work with transmission lines, safety standards classify products into several levels to meet proper requirements. Take an average cable conductor, for example. It is surrounded in plastic, which can easily burn. So, cable manufacturers have developed materials to protect cables from fire. Some of these materials limit the spread of fire and also prevent release of toxic and opaque fumes. Flames can kill you, but smoke? Wow, watch out! Other cables have a flame deterrent to limit the propagation of fire. And most cables today are fire resistant and will continue to function if a fire occurs. That way, there is no disruption in the grid. But it is not all about cables. Critical electrical circuits are also made fire resistant. Why? Because we need them in case of an emergency. Some examples of critical electrical circuits are life support circuits, emergency lighting, fire detectors, alarms, and ventilation and door systems. And thanks to all those scientists around the world, new and innovative ways to use electricity are being developed every day. So that's all for me. Goodbye from Nexans, Chile. Thank you for having me, Frederick.
It seems like my friends covered just about everything today. It's always nice to have support. Makes the job easy. All right, we are not done yet. Here is a quick review. Electricity is dangerous when the motion of electrons is disrupted within a given conductor. A short circuit occurs when a current travels along an unintended path. With utilities, short circuits can lead to breakage, heating, ignition, or explosions. For humans, contact with a short circuit can cause burns, radiation, shock, and deflagration. 30% of fires are caused by electrical issues. And remember, stay vigilant during your DIY projects. Make sure you respect the existing legal codes, regularly inspect your equipment, keep up to date on repairs, and of course, replace those outdated or malfunctioning circuit breakers. By following these simple rules, you can help reduce the risk of an electrical hazard occurring in your home. That's all for this episode of What's What. Until next time,